Hey guys, so you're not gonna believe what we're doing today. Actually, you will because you read the title. But we are jumping back in with some mini reviews, and I left off with October 2018. So I did October 2018 part one. I had to split up that month. Apparently, I got a lot of stuff that month. And now we're gonna be doing part two. So if you guys are new to my channel, which I think a lot of you are since the last time I did this, because it's been a long time. What I did like to do, or what my goal was to go back a few months and do mini reviews and just kind of revisit some things that maybe I didn't include in favorites. They weren't a worse product. So these are just kind of like quick mini reviews of, all the products that I talk about in a certain time frame. And like I mentioned, I left off with October 2018 part one, and now we're going to be doing part two, which is still like plenty of products. So let's go ahead and just jump right in. I left off with the Viseart Libertine palette. This is one of their nine pan palettes. I love this palette. I think it is really different. I love the color story. I think it's a lot of fun. When I got it onto my eyes, the first thing I thought of immediately was that I got this very kind of like 80s, like punk kind of look. I don't know what, maybe it's this purple down here, but the quality is Viseart quality. But I know a lot of people think that these shimmers are a little bit soft. They could be amped up a little bit, but I happen to like them. I think they're great in real life. I love Viseart shadows. I love the quality of them. They blend really nicely, and they're never really, at least for me, they're never really like a surprise. They're kind of like what you see is what you get in terms of like the color. And I like that. I really, really like that. So that's the Viseart Libertine palette. And then I talked about the By Terry Eyelight palette. It's the palette that had like the longer pans. Anyway, I got rid of that palette. It was not very good at all. If you go back and watch that video, which you don't have to because I'm going to tell you now, I used it and I felt like the first half of the shadows were like powdery, not pigmented, nothing. And then the right half of the palette, the deeper colors, were actually pretty good. So I was able to get like a fairly decent eye look, but I never reached for that palette. I pretty much got it because it had this like imprinting, like a skyline printing over all of the shadows in there. So it was just a really cool palette, but it just, I don't know, it just didn't really work for me. So I decluttered that palette. I also decluttered the Bobbi Brown Infrared palette. This palette was okay. I got it during one of those Sephora Rouge member like holiday preview events. I went into store and my Sephora actually, I remember, didn't have that much stuff. This was like the one thing that I was like semi-interested in. So I just went ahead and purchased it because I think that's the only thing I got. Maybe I got a couple things. But anyway, I picked that up during an event like that and it was okay. It was okay. I don't know. I don't always have the best luck with Bobbi Brown shadows when they come in a palette. When I've bought her individual shadows, when they came in those like the square packaging with like the clear top, or her chrome like luxe shadows, those baked ones that came in like the gold compact, I love those shadows. But for some reason, I don't know, Bobbi Brown compacts are not my favorite. This one wasn't as bad as some of the ones that I experienced. So this one was definitely, it was good. It was good, but it wasn't great and it wasn't my favorite. So I decluttered that. And then next I talked about the Chantecaille Holiday 18 collection. It feels so weird to say that now. The Chantecaille Holiday 18 collection. And this was the one that had the Moonlit, whoops, the Moonlit Pearl Glow powder. Sorry, that's unhelpful. That's just the packaging. But it was this guy. And this powder is so gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. This was also the 20-year anniversary for Chantecaille. Oh my God, it's so soft and beautiful. And it's just this really soft, pearly sheen of a powder. So you can use it as a very subtle highlight, or you can use it as like a finishing powder. It's just gorgeous. And it has just like the softest sheen ever. It's so, so beautiful. That collection also had the Blythe Brilliant Lip Gloss. Absolutely love it. This color is so pretty, so, so pretty, and it has little sparkles in there. I love, love the Chantecaille Brilliant Lip Glosses. They're heavenly, heavenly on the lips. This was also when I purchased my very first Chantecaille lip veil, which is one of my all-time favorite lipstick formulas. So this is in the color Baobab, and I just love it. I absolutely love it. It's a great color. I have since then purchased colors that I wear a little bit more often. They're a little bit more neutral than this Baobab, like Honey Pot and Tambodi, I think is the other one, I really love. And then the Frangipane, which is like a bright orange, I also wear that one as well. So anyway, I love the formula of those. And then they also came out with two colors for their Le Perle metallic liners, Argent and Violet. And I think this was the second time, I'm not sure, but I think this was, for me, the second time that they included these Le Perle metallic liners in like a limited edition collection. So I love these liners. So I have four of them. I have a green and a blue, which is, I think, the first time I came across these. I don't know if they came out with them before this, but this, I believe, was before this silver and purple one. Whew, I love these liners. So they're a liquid liner and then they're metallic and it has like a brush applicator. They're just absolutely gorgeous. And a lot of people were curious as to whether, you know, like the metallic bits like flaked off or anything. I experienced that with like those Sisley waterproof liners. I think I mentioned that in my worst products for my favorite brands. This, I didn't experience that with this. These go on smoothly. They stay put. Absolutely love them. I hope they come out with more colors. And then they also came out with a Le Chrome Luxe Duo in the Kenya colorway. So I think this came out for fall. I think it was before the holiday collection. But I love these Le Chrome eyeshadows. They're just really, really shiny and pretty and stunning. And the duos are great. You can get a complete eye look with any of the duos that you pick up. And I have two other ones. I have Grand Canal and oh God, what's the name? I just picked up one and I love it. It just appeared in one of my favorites and now I can't remember the color name. Anyway, I love these. The only thing I don't like about these Le Chrome Luxe Duos is the packaging. This like clasp thing, this like little lock thing, it doesn't work. So when I press it down, like basically this is just loose. So even when I'm able to press it down, it's just loose. So that is very, very annoying. Otherwise it's gorgeous. I mean, it's gorgeous packaging. The C of the Chantecaille is, this like, plastic like glitter and, you know, great mirror. Anyway, everything else is beautiful. Just this clasp and on all of them, they've broken. So I hope they fix that or change the packaging altogether because this is kind of annoying. All right, and then I did dedicated videos to each of the Pat McGrath the smaller Mothership palettes. This was like the second go around that she did. And this was for the holidays. I think these are discontinued, which is such a shame, but this one is the Bronze Temptation and this one is lovely, absolutely lovely. So this is one that had like the red and the green in there. This is actually perfect for the holidays. And then there was also Metamorphosis and this is the one that had like all of the metallic tones in there and they're all just shimmery, like crazy shimmery shades. That purple is gorgeous. And then this one happened to be my favorite out of the three. This one is the Dark Star one. I just thought this one was so unique and I really, really loved it. It was just unique, like I said. And this Entice color is so gorgeous. And then, yeah, you just get like a really smoky, different look. And it's just, it's great. And it's very like Pat McGrath, I feel like. So I love all of these palettes. The Dark Star is probably my favorite out of these three. Okay, and then I did like a luxury lipstick roundup. So I'm just gonna talk about them very quickly instead of just pulling them all out. The Le Bouche Rouge lipsticks, I love those. Those are the refillable lipsticks that have the leather casing on the outside. They're so, so gorgeous. I love them. And in fact, I'm sitting here thinking I should have included them in my gift ideas. I mentioned like the House of Sillage, I mentioned the Bond Number 9, but these Le Bouche Rouge are more understated. You know, they're not quite as flashy, but they're so luxurious. And the lipstick formula is vegan and they're just wonderful, wonderful lipsticks. The Tom Ford Satin Mattes, I don't like the formula. They go on really slick, but then I feel like they dry out my lips. So I don't like those. The YSL Tatouage Couture Metallic Finish. That was okay, but I felt like it went on a little bit patchy. So not my favorite. Sisley Lafitte Rouge lipsticks. Love those. I've talked about those a gazillion times since then, so I'm not gonna linger there. The Chantecaille lip veils, I just talked about, love it. Love the formula. The Clé de Peau lipstick cashmeres. These are actually very similar to the Tom Ford satin mattes, so I don't like these either. And if you like the satin mattes, you'll probably like the lipstick cashmeres, but they just have a very intense silicone-y feel. Like, they glide on and you're like, oh wow, this is so smooth and soft. But I don't know, something about once they set down, they just feel really, really drying on my lips. Like an hour and a half into it, I'm like, I have to remove it. So not a fan. And then the Charlotte Tilbury Superstar lips. Those are those skinny lipsticks. I don't like those either. There was a thickness to them that I didn't like. And I think, yeah, I've decluttered those. And then I did a haul. So Aesop, a Rose by Any Other Name body cleanser. I've long used that up. I think I've repurchased it a couple times since then, but I had some other kind of like, you know, foaming body washes that I had to get through. Otherwise, I would go back and repurchase this immediately. It is an amazing cleanser. I love the smell of it. The rose is very, very faint. It's not like overpowering at all, but then there's this like pepper scent in there. So it's just, there's like a little bit of spice. Oh, it's so lovely. I love that body cleanser. The Aesop Rind Concentrate Body Balm that is in my bathroom right now. That can't be the same one. So this has got to be a repurchase of that. Yes. So I really like that. The rind flavor or scent of the Aesop is like very citrusy. Absolutely love it. It just wakes me up. The Kypris Cerulean Mask. Love this mask. This is the very first Kypris product that I tried, and it is kind of like a gel mask, and I love it. It's so cooling. I love using it when my skin feels a little hot and angry. I love it in the summertime. I love it when I travel. It's wonderful. So I love that mask. The Guerlain Meteorites Electric Pearl. So that is these guys right here, and this is what it looks like. So this is definitely much more shimmery than the regular meteorites. And so this makes for just kind of a great like highlighter, or if you're doing kind of like a holiday look and you don't mind, you know, like micro glitters kind of everywhere, then this is for you. It's a little bit shimmery for me to use every day, like instead of the regular meteorites, but it is really, really lovely. And it does have the violet scent, which I love. Absolutely love it. So I do enjoy this. And when I am feeling a little frisky, I will like buff my highlight in with this, like use it as finishing powder, but over my highlight area. And it really just really makes it sparkle. It really gives it like kind of like an ethereal finish. So these were, I believe, the limited edition meteorites from last holiday season. And then I hauled the Sisley Revitalizing Fortifying Serum for Scalp. Now this was probably the second bottle that I used, because I'm on my third bottle. So I absolutely love it. My hair was feeling a little sad before I started using the serum, and it has really, really changed the health of my hair. I just feel like it's so much healthier. And you know, because it's just a serum for the scalp and it just feels really great. You just massage it in or whatever. I will say it took some time for me to actually notice a difference, but I remember using this scalp serum and then having to go away for a while, for like 2 weeks, and I didn't bring it with me. I was like, oh, that's fine. It wasn't fine. I really feel like I could see a difference. My hair just seemed a little bit more limp. Like, it just seemed a little bit more sad. It's just wonderful. I love this serum for scalp. The Retrieve Luminous Cleansing Elixir. I'm like probably on my fifth or sixth little bottle of that. That's in my bathroom right now. I absolutely love it. And then I picked up this Edward Best Precious Pearl Perfector. And I haven't used this too much. It's really, really beautiful. When I was using the Victoria Beckham Estee Lauder collaboration, that Morning Aura Illuminating Cream, and that was limited edition, so many of you suggested me to get this. And I love the texture of it, but the metallic-ness in this, like the Morning Aura Illuminating Cream just has this very kind of like light gold effect. This actually has like a pink kind of metallic effect to it. And so it's not something I like to use every day on my face. So I've used this several times, I'll say, since then, but it does leave kind of like this pink, it's subtle, but it's a pink kind of iridescence versus a gold iridescence. And I just prefer the gold. So it's lovely and I do like the formula of it, but it's definitely not something I reach for very often. And I'm a little bit embarrassed about this next product, because when I saw this on my list, I was like, what is this? I didn't even remember this. So this is the Edward Best Marbleized Rose Gold Powder. This is a lovely powder, but it has really just gotten lost in my collection. But it has, I don't know if you guys can see, it has there, like marbling between like a peach, a white, and a gold. And so it makes for like a really bright highlighter. So there's like a subtle sheen to it, but it's really just like the color of it is what's gonna kind of like lift your cheek, not so much the reflectiveness. So I completely forgot about this. I'm embarrassed to say, but it is a lovely product. And then I hauled this Armani Quad number 2. So Armani had just like redone all of their quads and they kind of reshaped them all and everything. I really, really like these quads. And in fact, you can see how much I enjoyed it. And I believe this appeared in one of my favorites kind of soon after I purchased this. This is such a great like everyday quad. It's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And I was just recently thinking about these quads because, you know, Barney's going out of business and they've been having a sale online and they had these quads there and I was thinking about getting them and I thought, oh my gosh, I barely use the ones that I have and I love the ones that I have. So I kind of stopped myself and I think this needs to come out in like one of my Shop My Stash videos because this is so beautiful. I love it, absolutely love it. So that is the Armani Beauty Quad number 2 is the color, Avant Premiere is the name. And then last but not least, I hauled the Eyes to Kill number 3 in Armani. I have not used this recently, I'm sorry to say, but this is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Like instant smoky eye. In fact, I'm gonna leave this out with my number 2 quad and use them this week because, oh, amazing, absolutely amazing. And the texture of these is really nice. Like there's definitely a soft, creamy silkiness to them. They're a little bit like smoother than the Chanel. The Chanel like kind of feels like putty, but they're not as loose as the Tom Ford or the Charlotte Tilbury, which are like moussey. I really like these. I think these are a little bit closer to like the Chantecaille. So smooth. Look at how it blends. Look at the edges of that. It's like instant blending. So that is the Armani Eyes to Kill in number 3. So that is it for this mini reviews. Sorry, I just kind of like blew through all of those because there's so many products to get through and I definitely want to, you know, kind of do a lot of these during Mishmas. So definitely stay tuned and definitely subscribe down below if you're into these mini reviews and I'll see you in my next video.